your body, that's more than enough. So we're arching and rounding, feeling our shoulders, feeling our neck, and articulating our body with breath to warm up. To warm up the spine, to warm up in the mind. High plank. On the knees. Scapular push-ups again. So you don't even have to go on the knees if you're already set with your shoulders and you've got that shoulder integration, chest open. Scapular push-ups, 10 of them. The shoulders will just work up away from the ear, shoulder blades squeeze, and you push the opposite action. 5, this works quite a bit. 4, I'm gonna come up close, keep doing this. 3, on or off the knees. 2, keep doing this. 1, I wanna show you guys what's happening with my shoulders so that you can see you are on or off the knees. So I'm pushing and flossing, pushing, flossing. Pushing, super good for your stabilizers. Now, whole high plank on or off the knees, add on regular push-ups, 10. Focus on the smooth lowering and the smooth lifting. On or off the knees, use your belly, moving as slow as you like. You can even hold high plank. 5. That's the rain, beautiful, quiet rain that we keep our island so green and healthy too. Hold it on the low, little baby pulses. Wrap the belly in, just stay. Notice the shoulder heads are set from those scapular push-ups, so the chest is broad. Feel the triceps a little, chest. Give yourself a break as needed. Left palm down, right arm up. So we're still calm amongst this. You know, that's part of what makes it a mindful workout. Feel the right arm up. I have a lightweight in my hand, a very lightweight in my hand. It's 5 pounds, knee to knee. You can use no weight. Lengthen, hug the belly in, and move at your own pace, dipping the hip. So the left shoulder is now bearing weight. So you want that chest open, the left shoulder head away from your ear. Feel the bottom hip, top leg, and breathe. Keep going. Just one set of these on each side. Taking a little bit of time here. Can you feel the action? 3. Fun to move the body in this way. Hold it on the top. Bring the light weight of your hand to the right thigh. Turn the right toes down a little, just loose hovers. But you're not doing a lot of stuff with the trunk of the body. You're staying still with the trunk of the body. Energizing the side of the right glute. Wrap the belly in, hold, push the leg away. Belly supports you with breath. Gentle release. Stretch as you need, take break as you need. Start with a few scapular push-ups, shoulder blades squeeze in, and the other way, in, the other way. Set them to a balance in between those two. Chest forward, push-ups. Maybe widen the hands to get a little more pecs. Can you feel how the belly supports you on the way up and down? And you're not, this is not a clench or force or a fight. We're fighting some action. Energize, stimulate the body, get stronger in the tissues. But it's not necessarily helpful to destroy. Our intention, I want to remind us, is not to destroy our body. It's to love our body, to make it healthy and strong. So just do what you can to your edge. Some of you might be going a lot faster than me, which is fine. Some of you might do less. You may be off your knees. Take it for you and relax your neck. Find your breath, hold it on the low, and 2. We'll hold it on the low and see if you can mula bandha, squeeze a little inner hug. Just baby pulses. Feel that exhaustion. Come back, right knee down on the ground. Left arm up, smooth rows. Setting that right shoulder, so the right shoulder is opening away from the ear. The trick is, with the shoulders, when you're bearing weight on the shoulders, it's not to round the shoulder forward. Okay, so the stabilizers. Now, left leg up, your own pacing. To feel the action along the way. So mindful workout means we are being with every part of it, not just counting down to get them done, to finish, because we know we'll feel good after. We're seeing if we can be with process along the way. We don't need to miss out on any of it. We get to be here for this part too. We get to indulge in the glory of how strong our body and mind are. So that bottom hip, smooth. Less jerky than you think. We're just smoothing it down. And up, three, two. Okay, one. Do a full round when you can. This one sort of sneaks up on you, doesn't it? Lift up, bring that weight to that side of the left thigh. You know that side of that thigh. Pulse it up. Keep the hips and the belly trying to stay set. Just bring that left leg high up and a little energetic squeeze. Belly supporting you. Right shoulder supporting you. Hold and reach. Yes. Lower the weight with care. Down dog. Walk it up. Hop forward to squat. Relax your hands. Hop back to down dog. Again, hop forward. On your own, you can walk. Some people, I got some questions about what do you do if hopping hurts your knees or doesn't feel good. Absolutely great question. You don't need to hop. You don't need to try to get that hop in. See how I'm doing this? I'm not hopping at all. It's usually one leg at a time. And it's still pretty challenging. Up to you on that. It's not a better way than the way that you're choosing. Three. Hands up. Two. Knee in a squat. Okay, so feel the wrists, open the inner thighs, preparing for our weights, sun A, use the weights with care, lower and lift, drop the weights when you don't need them with care, up and down, bicep curl, butt back, belly in, overhead, this is a variation of sun A, you don't need to over clench that butt in a tuck, it tends to just clench up the sacrum, but do what feels good, squeeze the butt on the way down, just not with clench. With energy, weight so lightly to the earth, a chaturanga or a mountain climber you choose, just a quick walk or hop, bicep curl, exhale overhead, pushing, feeling the full body, chaturanga or mountain climber, and back up. I'll show you the version without hopping now. Walk back, hold, maybe a knee to nose with care. Knee to nose and walk forward, just switching the legs every time if possible to get a balance, to work toward balance. Maybe skipping the chat. Let's go for, I want us to try for 30 seconds here. Get your own pace, let the neck relax. Once you got the move, focus on you. Don't worry about what I'm looking like. Feel you, feel your body, feel the full body move in this way. Breathe. Five more seconds, try for one to three more rounds, depending. Meet an overhead press, right here. Overhead press, butt back. Overhead press, butt back. Yes. Okay, now we're getting going. Feel how you can feel the glutes on the way up and down. Move at your own pacing. Five. Check this out. Belly is supporting you, glutes are back, and you're pushing the floor away with your feet. Now maybe close your eyes. How can you use the legs and the hips to your advantage? Go from the power source, your core, your glutes. Three. So notice, I don't recommend this necessarily, okay? I recommend happy, neutral, but do what feels good for you guys, okay? I just really want us to get to a point where we're doing workouts ourselves along the way. Not saying other workouts hurt ourselves. Just saying you can do any workout in the world when you're mindful and you're aware of how it feels in the body, how it feels after. Hold it low. Oblique rinse. Yeah, I really want to make that clear. I'm not trying to say this is better than another. There's so many brilliant ways. There's so many. So what? In this moment now, can we train ourselves to be more present? We're oblique rinsing with breath of fire, adding a little flavor to make it kind of fun. Now you close your eyes. Feel the obliques breathing, pumping the belly. Digestion, helping all the stuff go fluid. Efficient hold, center. Feel it. Reverse lunges, switching the legs along the way. Belly supports you. So I'm kind of just, this is pretty mellow, right? But it's fun. Take it up a notch. Lower and longer, full stance. Add the squat. That's up a big notch. Up one more notch. Bicep on the top. And back. We're using a little bit of momentum to get into flavor, to get into rhythm. Your own pacing. You do not have to match my pace. You can go slower, you can go faster. I like to try to hover the back knee to the ground and kiss it up. You don't have to. It's way easier to not bend the knees, which might be a nice thing. How about your exhale? Notice if your jaw is fine. Relax the tissues of your mouth. You don't have to strain your jaw tissues to get the workout. Working the resilience of our body. Just three. Meet with the right leg forward. Right here. My right foot's forward. Screen, it looks left, but it's my right. Left knee down, bicep curl. Rise. Left knee down, bicep curl. Rise. 10. Doing the bicep curl when my legs are isometric. That means they're staying still and they're engaging. A lot of yoga is isometric, which is pretty cool. All the different exercises are wonderful. It's good to vary it up, I think. 5, 4. Feel the heat start to build. Yeah? 2. I don't know. I don't even know what I'm counting here. So stay down when you're ready. We're just doing enough to get it. You know, how about the left knee all the way down? I might just opt for that one today and be kind to myself. Maybe feel the power by hovering. Check out that front knee is directed forward. It's directed forward. Happy bodies. 4. Just bicep curls, smoothing it out. 3. Chest broadens. Serve the weights forward. Still in that nice isometric hold. Anjaneyasana. Stretching out the left psoas along the way. Getting the right butt. 2. That's all. Pulse the weights up. Lean back so the belly supports. Get that stretch in that left hip crease at the back leg. Weights to heart, shoulders. 1 more move. Left leg up, it's a big move. This is one leg Tadasana. Maybe weights overhead. Balance the hips. Warrior 3. Right foot is supporting you. I'm not in a huge one, I'm just kind of mild there. Left foot down. Frame your front foot. Right leg pulses up and squeeze just for long enough. You can throw in a chaturanga, why not? Right foot through, push, same leg. Right glute takes you up. Knee to knee. One leg or kick. Weights. 3. Lunge. Frame. Squeeze. Full body movement with care. This one sneaks up on you. We get switch legs. Take some pressure out of the right glute, which we're working here. We're working our belly, working our arms, working everything. Full body. Right foot through. How about 3 more? Maybe 1 more. Maybe 0 more. Maybe 10 more if you're going super fast. Squeeze that right butt. Keep the belly down. We meet in plank position. Go for it right now. Right, maybe weights to the side, right leg, knee to nose, or mountain climber. We're switching the legs up. You might be aware that the right glute is more fired up than the left. We work the right side. Push the floor away, set the chest. You can do high knees here instead. You do not need to hop. You do not need to hop. You can keep it here. You can be on the knees. See that? Belly. Belly. Exhale. Or double time. Maybe get a little extra. You glide it in you. Get a little extra quick sprint. 3, 2, 1. Right leg lifts. Same side. Open the hip. Just let it feel good. Low lunge. Grab the weights all the way up to the heart. Rows. Right thigh stays bent, catching the breath a bit here, or float the left leg, warrior three, up to you. So, lunge, squeezing shoulder blades, or floaties, either one. Maybe stay here, pretty hard. Five. Yes, you guys, we got this. 3. It's pretty phenomenal to be able to work out in this way. 2, hold the pulse right here. Energize that back foot. Lower that leg. Right butt's burning. So show. Kick it back. 30 seconds. Smooth. Smooth. Check out what your neck is doing. Right thigh is low. Back heel, that's your left leg, is lifted. High up over the toes to engage it. Hips are lined up. Mindful. Triceps. You can lower that right thigh more if you need more, or straighten it if you need less. 3. Short set. Flip the palms up. If the shoulders are rounding, you gotta let the shoulder heads, shoulder blades squeeze in. 5, 4, 3. Pulses. 2, 1. Weights to heart. Lower down. Shake out the right leg for a break, just for a moment. Right foot through. Knee up. Tap, knee up, maybe add the oblique. Keep going, add your hop if you want. Variation, mild variation. Mild variation. More, lower. More, hop. Just 10. Light hop. Absolutely don't need to hop. Just spring up. You got more, you can, whew, power it up there. Go for 4 more. Have an exit. Not to be hard on yourself, just take it to your edge. 2. Hold it on the low right here. On the low, this is the last 30 seconds of this side. I'm telling you, it's the last 30 seconds right here. You guys are like, sure. She's gonna throw in something else. I was thinking about it. So, check it out. The butt is low. Push through that right foot. You could be way more upright here. 1 set. Can you feel that right butt burn? You're like, yes, we feel it burn. Do you feel it burn? Maybe faster, but it's not gonna get done any sooner. Savor in the sensation. Try to get the butt lower, lower than you think. Right butt, right hamstring. Side of the right butt. 5. Hold the squeeze in 4. Feeling that whole butt cheek too. Right here, squeeze hands to heart. Moving through vinyasa in 5, 4, 3, 2. Add your vinyasa flow. How about a handstand? Or a little hop. Vinyasa it out. Meet a down dog. Lock it out. Hop forward. Hands up. Hop back. Or this time, donkey kicks. Heels to butt, slight spring. Maybe catch some air time. You also don't have to bend. Here's the option without hopping. For some of you that have been asking me, see this? Meet at the top of the mat. Quicker for this, not quicker in speed, but not as long. So then that bicep curl overhead. Feel the difference with the right glute and the left glute. Mountain climber or chaturanga. Ha. Ha. I'll show you without hopping. Walk it back. Switch your legs. Lock it up. 3, 2. Feel the power in your body, in your mind. Overhead press right here. Weights down. Butt back. Maybe tippy toes. Maybe keep the legs low. Five. Shorten, shorten. Three. Two. Belly. All the way up. Yes, you guys. Oh, class is more than halfway done. I can't believe how quick we have the bike. We have the jab. Jab. So it's similar to this with the breath of fire. But adding on. Faster, slow. Obliques. Keep the elbows bent. Maybe athlete. You got the combo. What? Two. One. Hold. Reverse lunges. Simple. Tap. Switch legs. Flavor it up. Or, this is way bigger because you're bringing that knee low. Palms out at a 45. With a little bit of the momentum, we add the bicep on the top. Seven. You can also go halfway in between and do a little one. Just be aware of what you're doing. That's the trick. Left foot will land forward after a few more rounds. Left foot will land forward right here. Hold the lunge. Right knee's low. Bicep curl. Belly supporting you. Rise. Right knee maybe all the way to the ground. Bicep curl. Rise. Right knee. 10. Legs are working toward 90 degree angles. Left knee is directing forward. Center of knee. Step the inner two. Second and third toe. Keep that knee in line. How about four? Belly. Notice that the chest and the shoulders are rounding forward. Three. We're holding on the bottom. In one more. Hold on the bottom here. Just the bicep. This should feel pretty challenging. That back hip crease is spreading as you lift the belly. Tendency is to kind of start to round and collapse and lay into the low back a little bit. Or lay into the low back like this. See what's happening? Spread so you have space for the low back. Three, two, elbows squeeze in, serve the weights out, creating a W with the arms. Five, not too many. Four, should be burning pretty good here. Three, belly supporting you. Hold and pulse, chest broad, belly in. Do what you can. Shoulder blades squeeze, shoulder heads back, away from ears, belly in. Weights to heart, you did it. Right leg, core up. Balance out the hips, maybe weights overhead. Find your warrior three, dig the right heel back. Left hip crease back. Not in a rush. Lunge. Buoyant. Weights down. Left glute does a squeeze and a lift in this extension for that glute maximus. Bring it through. All the way through, so right knee up. Overhead. Down. Weights through heart. When you bring that left leg back, you can of course add a chaturanga. When you feel the sit bone, where you sit, where it goes dormant a lot for a lot of humans, and that wants to fire, that's gonna help your back. It's gonna help your back. Okay, most all cases. Not all, but most. It can't hurt, it will help. That goes dormant, that lower part of the glute max, it's a huge muscle, but we sit down on it and smush it. Does that mean sitting on is bad? No. You know, I don't think it's that fun maybe at that chakra to live like that. Like we should do this or shouldn't do this. Maybe just finding the balance. Maybe just being less hard on ourselves. Something like that. Feeling this moment. Feeling the temperature increase even though we're not moving super fast. We're caring. I've checked out calories for a lot of different workouts. This tends to burn more, and you're in a most of the time you're in a fat burning zone, which I think is pretty phenomenal. Left thigh, because we're not trying to kill ourselves. Three more. We'll meet in high plank, and let's go for one more. You have really no opportunity to be thinking about anything other than that squeeze and the chaturangas you've been adding. Push that left glute. We have a mountain climber set coming up. Weights to the side, so you can palm and set the shoulders. How about knee to opposite armpit? What about no bouncing or no hopping? Woo! That's pretty good. In a way, I might even get more action out of that. This is for fast twitch muscle. Gen Mac. Let's see those high knees, Gen Mac. Let's see, this is another one. Or here. Here, if you don't want to wear weight on your arms. Look at this baby. Exhale. Exhale. Okay, so take it to you, Gen Mac. Arms up. Or whoever else wants to do high knees. Knees up. Get that quick. Get that quick twitch. 20. 19. It's going to end in 15 seconds. How can you feel this moment now? Right now. Right now. 5. 4. Right now. 3. 2. Left leg lifts. Good job. Open. Feel that hip. Give yourself a stretch. Lunge. Plant the foot. With care. Use your belly. Getting toward the ladder for the class. So be aware. Weights come to heart. Rows. Last time we had the left of space for. In fact, if you want something slightly different, weights come in front of you and then out. A little bit harder where you can do rows. Left foot's down. Yes, you guys. Left foot supporting you, right toes. Maybe they're behind you. You can have the elbows bent a little bit here. 5. Left glute is on. Maybe the right leg's lifted a bit. Chest is opening. Triceps coming up in 10 seconds. Smooth. We hold the pulse in 5 seconds. The shoulders. Feel the left glute. Hold the arms out to the side. A little bend and squeeze the shoulder blades in toward each other. Just a little. Bend the left knee. Weights come through heart. Plant right foot. Final set of triceps this time. Palms face up, elbows hug in, and just kick it back from there. See if you can kick it back from there. A little different angle for the triceps. Left glutes on. Lean. Elongate through the chest. 5. I'm counting every 2 to make it a little sneaky. The mind, you can kind of trick it, you know, it's so fascinating. Keep going. Push it back with care. Keep going. So in real life, we have actual 4 more until we pulse. 2 in imaginary life. I don't know. Lift the palms up and pulse. 5, 4 weights closer together. Squeeze them up. Belly, chest, shoulders open. Weights to hurt. Lower the weights. Give yourself a break as needed. Left foot down. We're really maxing out through that left side of the glute, back of the glute, the glute medius, glute maximus a little bit. Stabilizers when you come up. So you stabilize. Here's A. Add the twist. Here's B. Layer B. Tapping. Layer C. Adding a little giddy up. You don't have to touch the ground even if you do layer C. To be here, spring it. Here, spring it. The trick is to keep that left outer hip from collapsing, hugging it. You'll get the maximum out of that. Spring that 10. But feel every part of it. So rather than counting down to the end to get it done, we're training ourselves for this moment now. It's only one possible thing you could be missing out on ever in life. The moment that you're in right now. Right now. Right now. 3. Now I forgot. What's even happening? 2, 1. I mean, I felt like we could have stayed there forever. Do you a little bit? Tap the back foot. Limit. So, the butt tends to want to lift. You can also, depending on how it feels, you can use something to prop you up with. I want that left thigh low, left knee guiding over the left ankle, and you can use that left glute like you mean it. Last one before we find our vinyasa. 20, relax the neck. Let's get to know time better right now. Let's get to know how every second feels better. Let's get to know our own body, our own sweat, our own temperature, how we feel. Embracing how we feel. I know that you can do this now, right now for 10, 9, 8, spread. See if you can push this to 3, 2, and hold. Yes, you guys. Yes. Yes. I want to hug you. 5, 4, 3, tap. That back foot. Squeeze. Vinyasa. Maybe throw in that standing split. Ooh. Doggy. maybe a handstand. Some of you might want to flow right into your handstand. Vinyasa. Chaturanga. Last standing series coming up. Child's pose, down dog, grab a sit. We're right there. Down dog. Forearm plank. Let's do jacks or standing jacks. Elbows under shoulders, we have a tap out and a tap out. No hop, hopping, or wide jack in, standing jacks. Keep the butt from bounce. The butt's gonna bounce, but minimize that by hugging the outer hips in, out, in. We have 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Dolphin, stretch the shoulders. Maybe lift both elbows up at the same time for dog. Down dog, that is. Right leg up. Oh, yes. Bring the right foot through. Warrior two. Weights to heart. I'll face you. My right knee's bent. Warrior two. Chest press. Elbows in. And up. You're doing the chest press on the low. 10. Feeling the length of the armpit. Breathing. Pushing the floor away with the feet. Noticing if your right knee is coming in or out. Usually it tends to rotate in a little, which we actually want the knee over the ankle to support everything. 4, hold it on the low in 3, feel the chest, 2, now on the low, option to come to the right tiptoes, knee is forward over the ankle, just a couple, or rotator cuff, elbows stay hugged in though, squeeze shoulder blades, rotator cuff. Littler movement, littler, more deep, mindful muscles. 3, 2, pulse and hold out. Squeeze shoulder blades. This is it, just 4. Come higher to the tiptoes, come lower with the right thigh. Weights to heart. Squats. We got it, we got time. Squats and up. We'll start a little late, we'll end just a little bit. Little bit before. Okay. Here's our waves jack. Ready? So keep with the squats. You can add anything with the arms if you're hopping. So this is the first variation, squats, or stay low and add that in, out, can you stay pretty low here? Butt back, knees out, knees together, knees out, knees together. Toes out, toes together. Keep the weights close to your body. Exhale. Light landings. Only getting the inner thigh, outer thigh, inner thigh, outer thigh. Like a thigh master, squeezing it out, squeezing it in. Light. You can take this to your own level. Keep those chest open. You're still in squats. If you're still in squats, way to go. 5, 4, 3. Into the dojo right here. Add an uppercut. Stay low. Instead of blowing high, just stay low. Upper, 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 obliques, obliques, obliques. 3, maybe tippy toes both. Maybe you're lifting both heels, coming lower. Uppercut, uppercut. Chest open. Pull, breath out. Right knee bends. Add the row. My right knee's bending, Skandasana. Row. It's like a skater, so my toes are out a little bit. The knee is guiding over the ankle. Add on if you like. Knee up, arm up. Row. Knee up, arm up, tricep on the back arm as an ab, front kick on the right leg as an ab, not necessary. Lower down, hold, push up, minimize the landing and the takeoff. 5, yes, 4, if you want a little bit more, both arms up, makes it a little harder. 3, in 2, do another full round, your own timing, meet in low, hands to heart, pulse, double up the weight in the left hand if you've got it in you, 5 rows, right here, just 5, again, a lot of our purpose isn't necessarily to max out, it's the change that we're making is a full body workmanship, teammanship, 2, and hold in pulse and belly. Teammanship. Good ways to heart. Back to center. Squats. Squats. or last time of the whole class, which is coming toward the end. We're not doing this on the other side. 30, 29, get low. How about exhales? Shoulders. Show you the side view. But this back chest is a little bit forward. Just set the pelvis, feel the belly. You're pushing the weights in toward each other. Have the chest open. You don't ever have to hop. Do squats, you can do walk-ins. Out, in, smooth. You can do this. You're getting strong. Cardio is on. Fat is burning. Metabolism is boosting. 10, 9, 8, 4, 3. Yes, you guys. 2. Hold. Tippy toes. Hook. Hook. So I'm bending the elbow. Hooking. 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 Less momentum, more obliques. Breath, tippy toes maybe. Maybe you're lifting off the heels. Inner thighs here. Plie style. 3, 2, yeah, weights to heart, left knee. Stay right here for a row. Just one arm for now. Add on if you like, or stay right here, this is enough. Left knee bends. Arm up. Both arms. Kick back that left arm, so the whole body working together. Feel the low, so try to minimize the landing and the takeoff is where a lot is happening. A lot of action is required to push off and to land for everything. You have to rush that. 7. How about exhale from the top? How about both arms above the head? Pretty hard if you have, you know, 8 or 10 pound weights. I have 5 pounds right now. 4. Definitely do a little bit heavier on this one if you wanted. You wanted to alternate. Some of them lighter, some of them heavier. 2. Do another full round. Meet in that lunge, that side lunge. Knees opening out. Stay right here. Little pulses. Grab the weight in your right hand. Double up the weight if you can, unless it's super heavy. And add your row, squeeze the shoulder blade back. My left arm's on my left thigh, but it's really not pushing down. I'm trying to get stable through my left side. 3, squeeze the shoulder. Similar to the scapular push-up action for the shoulder blade, for those serratus anterior. 3, hold and squeeze. Short set, squeeze for the belly, for the oblique. Weights to heart, come on down. Butt low. Oh. Oh boy. Okay, we're gonna go to the other side. Bring the weights all the way to the ground. Pivot the back foot. Either burpees right here, feet forward, hop, push up, or hop it back, hop. You could also hold high plank. You could also do a sun A. No hopping, walking. No hopping, or might as well give it a go. You guys, 10, hop, 9, up to you, hop. Add the push-up or not. Spring it up. Neck is easy. 3, burpees. It's an added bonus, 2. One more, spring it up. Muted high plank, well done. Left leg lifts. Low lunge. Left foot plants. Grab your weights with care. Use your belly. We're getting at the end, so sometimes we collapse here. And focus. Last chest press. Elbows in. Left knee. Add on. So chest press on the down. Lift on the top. 10. Hold that warrior 2. Take a peek at your left knee. Center of left patella. Knee count. Over the ankle. Warrior 2. Getting stretched, getting workout all at the same time. One of the most efficient ways to work out I've ever seen. In my opinion. And when I mean efficient, I mean efficient, including health for the body, for the mind. Okay, 4. Chest. And of course, it's because I also like it. It's important to kind of like it, have a little joy factor in it. 2. full body is powerful. Hold it low, maybe come to the tiptoes. Can you chest press? Pecs. If the shoulders are aggravating, you do a different form. Weight heads touch into a circle. A circle, it's a little different for the shoulders. Arms above heads harder. Come to the tiptoes four. Hold the pose. How about lower the left thigh, belly in three. Relax your face, two. Hold the pulse back, higher on the left tiptoes, three. Two, squeeze, sit low. Weights to heart, well done. Shoulders and neck. Right there, less than a few minutes of standing. Take a stretch as you need. One hand down, jack. Other hand down, jack. So see how I'm not hopping here. And I'm still getting an oblique rinse and a squat. You could come to your tiptoes. Some of you are maybe already hopping. 10 each, starting now. One and one. Maybe kick the toes out. Maybe add a circle, opposite arm is coming down. Four, four, add that out. Three, three, power. Two, two, one, meet with the right. Keep moving. Five only, servers. To the right, five. You can, you can. We've been training for this. Three, 5 minutes is two. Exhale. Back to center. Ah. Grab the weights with care. Slowly, weights to the shoulders. Squat, sumo player, groin, hips, obliques. Exhale. Add that squat in the center, really get that squat. Four. Exhales. Energize the foot. You can do this. Two. This is one more each. One. One, hold on the bottom, just pulse. Butt stays low and pulse, elbows in our thighs. Last standing, and we hit the ground. We pull down, hit the ground, little pulses, pulse the knees in. And butt is really low, elbow, low the butt is, it's low. Chest, three, two, pulse the knees out, out, butt is back, belly's in, weights down. Take a stretch as needed, fine on one. Woo! Left hand down, star. I want you to get the oblique. If you need more, hand goes to the opposite foot. Tippy toes or hop. If the hand is going all the way to the opposite foot, check out. Make sure the hips are still staying stable and you're not dipping in one hip, outer hips hugging in. Maybe kick the toes out. If you're kind of doing this, like this, and you feel, wow, I could step it up a little bit. I could step up my game a little bit. We'll do this together. So, one hand down, butt back, toes out. See, little bit bigger movement. Three each. Two each. We're gonna do one and then one for good luck. One more for good luck. One. And one, hold it low, surfer to the left, five only, butt down, spring, 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 two 180s, this is the last 180, hold, grab the weights, that's endorphins, serotonin, dopamine, elbows in, inner thighs pulse. Pulse, chest lifts, catch your breath, feel the burn. Yes, walk to the right 10 times, just little movements. Keep the chest low, keep the outer hips hugging in. Three, two, walk back. Walk more to the left, just a little bit more, five, four, elbows stay ahead. Walk back to center. You don't need weights for this. Belly in, elbows to inner thigh, three. Walking back to center, two. And one, hold, one breath in. Exhale, release the weight, stretch. Put the weight to the side. Come all the way down to your left foot is bent. High plank. Chaturanga. Up dog. Down dog. Child's pose. Less than 5 minutes. Well done. Weight behind the right knee. Right foot stance to the sky, halfway down. Stance to the sky, halfway down. Lift your belly along the way. Let the belly and the outer hips hug in. So sometimes I see kind of this action. Look at for a second what I'm doing. Just contracting, extending my back. Getting not much out of this at all. And we have weight on our legs, so it like taps the back a little bit. What I want you to focus on is the outer hips hugging in. It's not bad. So you might as well get into that where that sit bone is. Right where that butt meets the hamstring. Lower part of the glute max that gets dormant on many, many, many people. We have five little movements. You're not coming all the way down. Using momentum up. That's a good move too. You're just doing half range through. Stamp the right foot up. Up. Just bring the right knee to a windshield wiper. Fire hydrant. Halfway down, all the way up. Same thing. Last thing on the side. Just short. Halfway down. Up. Just short. Hold the pulse in three. Two. Stabilizing. Left hip tends to sap. Hug that out of left hip in. Hold the pulse. Squeeze. Belly, chest. One. Massage it out. In between sides, forearm plank. Or high plank. Elbows under shoulders. Forearms parallel. We're still right there. Knees hover and stretch. Hover. Three. Adding on in two. Next time it hovers. The knees are bent. My side of my right hip is aiming toward the very center of my mat. Kisses it down. Forearm plank. I'm trying to aim. It's not going to go all the way. Obliques. Your own pacing. If this isn't working for you, you're not sure. You can do hip dips. You can do rainbows. A little more simple. Okay. This one's pretty juicy. You're doing that full wrap. Five. Four. Three. Two. Hold. Exhale. Yes. Belly in. Chest forward. Last thing in all fours. Weight behind the left knee. You can use a super heavy one since it's such a short duration. It's not too many reps. Bring that left foot all the way up and up and up. So the trick here is to envision the outer hips hugging in toward each other. What tends to happen is there's right hip sags. I'm over exaggerating it. Hug that outer right hip in. Keep the belly from doing and the hips stable. And you're pushing the left foot as high as it will go up without overarching the low back. Five. Push the leg, you're pushing the ceiling up. Three. Keep going. Two. Feel that left foot. Push up to get right where the butt meets the hamstring with the knees out a little bit. Hug the inner thighs in a bit. Hold and squeeze, but lift the belly. Push the floor away. Bring left knee to fire hydrant. Halfway down, all the way up for this variation. Try to hug the outer right hip in. Just five, four, pushing the floor away using your belly. Three, two, now hold it on the top and little baby pulses. Right hip hugs in, chest forward, squeeze. Lower the knee, release the weight. Lay down on your back. Take a sip of water as you need. Put your towel down. Lock in between the inner thigh. One set of these to get the weight to the chest. Dig the heels down. Take a big breath. Weight to heart. Heels are digging down. Lift up. Just one set. Find your range. Weight overhead. See if you can hollow the belly on the down so you get that really good. You can even stay here and breathe and get a very, very good core workout. Skip the crunch part. Could be phenomenal. Up to you. Or you can keep the weights to the heart the whole time. It's harder because you're using a little less momentum. And the weight, still trying to open the belly. It's a little bit harder. Do dig the heels down. Three, two, dig the heels down and in. Hold it on the top, weight to the ground. Weight hands behind you. So I have block inside my inner thighs. You don't have one. But it's a boat, low boat, to opposite and the opposite. So you're twisting here, using your hands or not. Squeezing the block if you've got it. Or a banana side. This takes us to a full set of bicycles. Other back, three, wrap the belly. Hands are light, lifting that butt up a little bit. As you twist, broadening the chest open. Two. One more each, energize the feet. Keep going, right in. Just to maximize the last 2 minutes that we have together. Last few minutes. Bicycles, maybe point the toes and flex. Alternate between the two. Point, flex. Blocks under my legs. You can also have hand behind you. Legs farther away from you is a little bit harder for the belly. Up to you. Three. Knee to the right leg. In two. Hold the right knee. Either hand or block pushes. One hand behind the head. Other leg lifts and lowers. Just halfway up. Not all the way up. Just halfway through. Might as well make the most of this too. Hold and squeeze. Inner scissor. Block pulses to the right. Scissor the inner thighs. Three. Energize the feet. Two. Bicycles. Last time. Under. Under. Just five. Knee to the left and forward. Three, two, one. Left leg. One hand behind that. Push the left thigh. Right leg up and down. Just five. Point. Flex. Point. Shoulderless. Push the thigh away from you with your hand or block. Lift both shoulders. Lift both shoulders up too. Hold. Leg straight. Scissor. Block to the left. Pull. Scissor the legs. Three. Two, one, legs block to the belly for fun. Pause, five, this is it, four, front the back. Three, see if you can move the block up and down. Two, one, stretch, and done. Okay.
Way to go, you guys. Deep breath, and we did lots of standing core today too with all those oblique rinses. Bend your knees. I'm gonna end the video in a moment. We'll finish cool down, and then we have the question opportunity. So let's just take one breath in bridge. Shoulder blades squeeze. Belly is stretching. Take a big breath in. Lower down. Happy baby. Massage your hips out.